Hello everyone, welcome to the Stock Trading Tutor channel. If you'd like to create a free DMAT account with Alice Blue, click the link in the description and fill out your details. You'll also get intraday recommendation calls and you can learn robo trading software for free. Now let's look at what is leverage trading. Now leverage involves borrowing a certain amount of money needed to invest in something. In the case of Forex, that money is usually borrowed from a broker. Now, Forex trading does offer high leverage in the sense that for an initial margin requirement, a trader can build up and control a huge amount of money. So let's look at an example for leverage trading. Suppose you invest $100,000 in a stock, but you only have $50,000 in your trading account. Using leverage, you could buy on margin of 2:1, which gives you $100,000 to invest in that stock. Now let's look at some of the important terms in leverage. First is buying power. This is the amount an investor has available, including leverage, to buy securities. Next is coverage or risk ratio. This represents the ratio of the net account balance in relation to the leveraged amount, the money that will have to be paid out. Next is margin calls. If the coverage ratio falls below the minimum requirements to maintain the leveraged position, this is the margin call. Next is closing positions. The investor must manage market risks closing positions before the coverage ratio reaches the minimum required level. Now, how does leverage work? First, you choose the asset you are interested in trading. Select the appropriate tab at the top for selling short or for buying long for your trade. Now, set the amount of capital you wish to invest in this trade. Set your leverage multiplier. This ratio differs depending upon the individual asset. Alternatively, you can also trade without using leverage by choosing 1x. Next, set your stop loss and take profit parameters. Then click set order to place the trade. The trades are executed immediately when the market is open. Now, leverage trades are processed by CFDs. So, which market should you use for leverage? First is the share market. A share is a unit of ownership for a particular company and is usually bought and sold on a stock exchange. You can use leverage products to open positions on thousands of shares from blue chip stocks to penny stocks. Next is indices. An index is a numerical representation of the performance of a group of assets from a particular exchange, area, region, or sector. As indices are not physical assets, they can only be traded via products that mirror their price movements, including CFD trading and ETFs. Next is Forex. Now, foreign exchange or Forex is the buying and selling of currencies with the aim of making a profit. It is the most traded financial market in the world. The relatively small movements involved in Forex trading mean that many choose to trade using leverage. Another is cryptocurrencies. Cryptocurrencies are virtual currencies that can be traded in the same way as Forex, but are independent of banks and governments. Leveraged product allows traders to gain exposure to major cryptocurrencies such as Bitcoin and Ethereum without tying up lots of capital. What can you do to minimize risk when trading with leverage? First, you can use stop loss. Applying a stop loss to close a trade in the event that market moves a specific amount against your position. Next is taking profit. Set a take profit order to automatically close your position when profit on your trade hits the amount you choose. Next is negative balance protection. Although not required by law, in the rare occasion in which market conditions cause your account's balance to go negative, you can use this. Next is advantage of leverage. First advantage is magnified profits. As profits are calculated using the full value of your positions, margin can multiply your returns on successful trades, but also your losses on unsuccessful ones. Next is gearing opportunities. Using leverage can free up capital that can be committed to other investments. The ability to increase the amount available for investment is known as gearing. Another advantage is shorting the market. Using leverage products to speculate on market movements enables you to benefit from markets that are falling, as well as those that are rising. This is known as going short. Next is 24-hour dealing. This is an advantage because through trading hours may vary from market to market, Certain markets, including key indices, forex, and cryptocurrencies markets, are available to trade around the clock. Now let's look at some of the drawbacks of leverage. First is magnified losses. Margins magnify losses as well as profits, and because your initial outlay is comparatively smaller than conventional trades, it is easy to forget the amount of capital you are placing at risk. Next is no shareholder privileges. When trading with leverage, you give up the benefit of actually taking ownership of the asset. Another drawback is margin calls. If your position moves against you, it may ask you to put up additional funds in order to keep your trade open. This is known as margin call, and you'll either need to add capital or exit positions to reduce your total exposure. Another drawback are funding charges. When using leverage, you are effectively being lent the money to open the full position at the cost of your deposit. Thank you for watching this video. For more videos on stock market and trading, please subscribe to this channel. If you'd like to create a free DMAT account with Alice Blue, click the link in the description and fill out your details. You'll also get intraday recommendation calls, and you can learn robo trading software for free.